It's time for our children's story, and as our custom is, our young people will be gathering money for Sabbath school and support their Sabbath school ministers. So as they come forward, please remember.
Another warning that came in and said that that there wasn't any waves big in Alaska, because it was an earthquake, and Alaska makes the waves come up and try to head towards the island all the way across the Pacific Ocean. The earthquake can make these waves come. Now, I did go to sleep, and I found out that there was no more waves, and that we, and there weren't even waves where the earthquake was. Well, I guess it reminded me of a Bible text, and the Bible text is on the screen, so I have to look at it and read it. It says, Luke 21, 25 through 26, and there shall be signs in the sun, and in the moon, and in the stars, and upon the earth distress of nations. That's the guy with trying to do the bomb. Only it was not true. Thank the Lord. Amen. Everybody say, thank you, no bombs. Thank you, no bombs. And then perplexity, the sea and the waves roaring. So then the tsunami would be like the sea and the waves roaring. And another one, it said earthquakes in the book of Matthew. Then it says men's hearts failing them for fear. Have you ever heard of heart failure? Well, sometimes people get scared and their heart stops. Boy. Looking after those things which are coming on the earth, for the powers of heaven shall be shaken. And then, here's the good news. Pretty soon, what's it say up there? Then shall they see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. And when these things begin to come to pass, then look up and lift up your heads, for your redemption draws nigh. Well, I want everybody to look up. Well, we can't look very far here, can we? Only see the ceiling, but one day we will look up and Jesus will be coming in the clouds. Now, what is my job in the meantime when all this stuff is going on? Am I supposed to get my heart all excited and, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. Should that be what I do? No. What am I going to do, Amber? I like the way you're hugging your brother. You know, that's the way Jesus hugs us. He just said that if you will just turn your heart toward me and say, dear Lord, I just want to be ready for your coming, not because of these scary things, but because I want to be like you. You know, it's not the signs of all this bad stuff that's going to make Jesus come back. You know what's going to help Jesus to be ready to come back? When you are ready, and you are ready, and you are ready, and I am ready. When my heart is turned towards Jesus every day, and then no matter what happens, I'm ready, right? I'm ready to serve him. I'm ready to say, I love you, Jesus. And we won't be afraid. We will just be, it'll be just like Amber's got her arms around her little brother there, just safe in Jesus' arms. Amen? Well, we're going to have a prayer now. And we're going to pray that we are looking toward heaven and not towards being afraid. Amen? Can you say, I want to look toward heaven? I want to look toward heaven. Amen. All right, let's pray. Father, we do want to look towards heaven. We want to look up because all these things are going to happen and they're just the beginning of sorrows. But we do pray, Lord, that you would please keep our hearts ready, because every day when we say, I love you, Lord, and we say yes to you, Jesus, then our hearts are ready. And we thank you for the blessing that if we believe in you, you've promised to receive us one day in heaven. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may go back to your seats.